Hello students, so in today's video we are going to study the first chapter of class 10th, that is life processes, and the first topic of this chapter is nutrition. But before going in detail of nutrition, we should know about the definition of life processes and what are the different life processes which are important for an organism. So let us start. Life processes. These are the basic processes that are necessary for an organism to stay alive. And different types of life processes which are very important in a human body are nutrition, respiration, transportation, and excretion. We will study about these different life processes in detail one by one. So first of all, let us take nutrition. So the first life process is nutrition. And what is nutrition? It is the process in which an organism takes in food, utilizing it for different functions in the body and releasing the waste product from the body. And if we are studying the nutrition, then we should know about the term balanced diet. So what is balanced diet? Balanced diet is a diet which contains all the nutrients. And what are nutrients? Carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins, minerals, water and roughage in appropriate amount. So the balanced diet is the diet which contains all the nutrients in proper amount. The types of nutrition are of two types, autotrophic nutrition and heterotrophic nutrition. Auto means self. The organisms which make their own food are known as autotrophic, and heterotrophic nutrition, it is the nutrition in which organisms are dependent on other organisms for their food. In autotrophic nutrition, there are two types of nutrition. One is photoautotrophic. In photoautotrophic, the organism takes the solar energy to make their food. But in chemoautotrophic nutrition, organisms take chemical energy to make their food, and we will study these in detail in next slides. So in autotrophic nutrition, the auto means self, and trophs means nutrition. So these are the organisms, or we can say that the autotrophic mode of nutrition in the organism is in which the organism synthesizes their own food by the help of inorganic substances such as water and carbon dioxide. And all the green plants are autotrophic because they are able to synthesize their food by the process of photosynthesis. Okay. This is the process of photosynthesis in which carbon dioxide and water combines in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll. So what is the function of chlorophyll? Chlorophyll traps the sunlight. Okay. And carbon dioxide and water will transfer this solar energy into chemical energy, and glucose is formed with the release of oxygen. That is very important for us. Okay, without oxygen we cannot survive. So this is the process of photosynthesis. And what are the steps of photosynthesis? First step is absorption of light by chlorophyll. As I have already told you, the function of chlorophyll is to absorb the solar radiations. Then the next step will be the light energy will be converted into chemical energy, and at the same time there is photolysis. Photo means light, lysis means breakdown. So, the breakdown of water in the presence of sunlight will take place, which results in the formation of glucose. Means the carbon dioxide will be converted into glucose, and glucose will be stored in the form of starch in plants. So, after going through these steps, we can easily understand that the raw materials which are used for the photosynthesis are carbon dioxide and water. Now, what is the site of photosynthesis? Photosynthesis takes place in leaves. Okay, till now we know that photosynthesis takes place in leaves, but the organelle which is responsible for photosynthesis is chloroplast. Chloroplast is known as kitchen of the plant cell, that you have already studied in class 9. And chloroplast also contain a green color pigment which is called chlorophyll, and chlorophyll help in trapping the sunlight, so it help in photosynthesis. And chloroplast are present in the mesophyll cells. Now, stomatas. What are stomata? Stomata are the minute opening which are present in the epidermal layer of the leaves. Epidermal means the outer layer of the leaves. And stomatas are also responsible for the gaseous exchange during photosynthesis. Matlab means the carbon dioxide will go inside the stomata and oxygen will release out in the exchange of carbon dioxide and oxygen. There is one more function of stomata, which is stomata helps in transpiration also. Okay, and what is transpiration? Transpiration is the removal of excess water from the surface of leaves. Okay, so stomata have two functions. First is they help in gaseous exchange during photosynthesis, and they also help in the transpiration. Okay, now there are two pictures. On one side there is open stomata and on other side there is closed stomata. Okay, in open stomata, in both the stomata there are two guard cells, okay, which surrounds the stomatal pore, and each guard cell have one nucleus and different many chloroplast. Epidermal cells have surrounded the, just a minute. These are epidermal cells, okay. These are epidermal cells and they surround the guard cells, okay. These are surrounded the guard cell, okay. So, this is open stomata and this is closed stomata. Now, the second type of autotrophic nutrition is chemoautotrophs, the organisms which use chemical energy to make their food is known as autotroph. Autotrophs, on the other hand, derive energy for their life processes from inorganic chemicals. The example is nitrogen fixing bacteria. If you remember, the leguminous plants have root nodules where this nitrogen fixing bacteria rhizobium is present, which convert the atmospheric nitrogen into the combined state that can be used by the plants. Okay, so here is the difference between photosynthesis and chemosynthesis. Photosynthesis is the process of making food by using sunlight, and chemosynthesis is the process by which organisms make their food by using chemical energy. So, here is the difference. All the green plants are photoautotrophs and the chemoautotrophs are sulfur bacteria, okay, nitrosomonas, hai na? So, these are the chemoautotrophic organisms. Heterotrophic nutrition. Heterotrophic nutrition is the mode of nutrition in which organisms directly or indirectly dependent on autotrophs. Okay, means they cannot make their own food. They have to dependent on other organisms for their food. Okay, and different types of heterotrophic nutrition are saprophytic. Saprophytic means the mode of nutrition in which organisms obtain their food from dead and decaying organic matter, means they get their nutrition from dead and decaying organic matter, and these organisms are called saprophytes. All the fungi and bacteria are called saprophytes. Now, second one is parasitic nutrition. Parasitic nutrition is the mode of nutrition in which organisms live inside or outside the body of organism. Okay, and the organism which take the nutrition is parasite, and the organism on which this organism, means the parasite, is dependent is called host. It means the parasite take nutrition from the organism, from the host, without killing it. Okay, तो ये क्या करता है, it take the nutrition. So based on this, there are two types of parasite. One is endoparasite, second one is ectoparasites. Endoparasites are the parasites which lives inside the body of host. For example, Ascaris, malarial parasite, Plasmodium. Okay, they live inside the body of host, means human. And ectoparasites are the parasites which lives on the body, on the outer, hai na? Outer means on the body, outside the body, hai na? Of the host. Example is Cuscata. Cuscata is a plant, amarbel jisko hum bolte hain. It they drive nutrition from the plants on which it lives. And lice are the, where they live? They live in our head. Lice, they suck the blood. Okay. Third type of heterotrophic nutrition is holozoic nutrition, and in this nutrition the organism takes in food, digest it, absorb it and assimilate it, and at the last the waste which is not digested will be released out of the body by the process of egestion. So here are examples. The examples are human beings and amoeba. All the organisms in which all these five steps, these are the basic steps of nutrition, take place, that is ingestion, digestion, absorption, assimilation and egestion take place, then the nutrition in that organism will be holozoic nutrition. And the definition of ingestion, digestion, absorption, assimilation and egestion we will study in next video, where we will study about the nutrition in human beings. Okay, here there is nutrition in amoeba. In amoeba there is nutrition which is holozoic nutrition. So holozoic nutrition means the food is ingested. What is this? This is pseudopodia. Okay, this is pseudopodia, and when this pseudopodia merge, then it will form this food vacuole. This is food vacuole which is around the food particle, and this food vacuole will release some enzymes which will help in the digestion of food. After digestion there will be absorption of the digested food by the process of diffusion in the body of amoeba. Then the size of amoeba will increase, means it the food will be assimilated. The digested food will be assimilated after absorption, and the waste which is not digested will be released out of the body by the process of egestion.
In the nutrition of amoeba,
so this is about the nutrition in amoeba. Digestion, absorption, assimilation and then egestion. Taking in of food is ingestion, digesting the food, then absorbing the food, then assimilation and then egestion. Okay. So thank you children for watching this video, and if you really like my video, then please like my video and subscribe my channel, that is Basic Biology, for more videos. And if you have any doubt in this video, then you can write in the comment section below. Thank you.